Hi all, in this video we are going to discuss Informatica Joiner transformation. So in Informatica, the Joiner transformation is an active transformation, and we use this Joiner transformation to join two data sources. So these two data sources are can be from different source systems or different locations or different file systems, and we can also join the data from the same source. So to join the two data sources, we need at least one matching column in the two data sources. And the Joiner transformation uses a conditional, and that matches one or more pairs of columns between two sources. So in Informatica, for Joiner transformation, we can use data sources as two relational tables existing in separate databases or same databases, are separate databases in different locations, and two plot files in potential different file systems, and from different ODBC sources, as well relational table and an XML source, relational table and a plot file source, two instances of the XML source, and creating a Joiner transformation. To create a Joiner transformation in Informatica Designer, this is Informatica Designer under transformation tab. So this is basically empty. So for this, we will discuss how to create a Joiner transformation in couple of minutes. So here these are the few steps how to create a Joiner transformation in Informatica Designer, and what are the properties that are existing in Joiner transformation. Here in this screen we can see the properties of Joiner transformation, and in this we can see the condition that we have to use in Joiner transformation for the two different sources. So here we will take a small example how the Joiner transformation is useful in Informatica. So, and in Informatica we have few joining types using Joiner transformation. So those are normal, master outer, detail outer and full outer. So to define the Joiner transformation type, in properties tab we have an option. So here we will see a small example. Here I am taking two tables in one database. So this is an employee table. In this employee table we have employee number, department number and salary fields, and we have another table. This table contains employee number and employee name. So now in another database I am taking a new table, that is like employee details. In this I am taking employee number, employee name and department number and as well salary. So here in this table I would like to load all these details. So this is our target table. So in target table I would like to load whatever the details that are exist in this employee table. I would like to load only those employee details into the target table, and I am not considering remaining records that are there in employee table. These 6, 7, 8, 9 employee IDs, I am not considering these record IDs. So we are taking only the, this is a just considered or just assume this is the master table, and we are loading only these master records into target table. So for this, in SQL Server I have a table call employee in source database. This is the database source. In this I have table the records same as we see in spreadsheet, and we have a table employee details. This is an empty table. In this we have two fields, employee number and employee name. So I am inserting the detail that we see that are stated in spreadsheet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and employee name. So I am inserting those records into employee details table. So 5 records are inserted. So these are the 5 records. And coming to the, so in target database, So this is a clear statement. I have used it to create a table in our target database with a employee name, department number and salary details. So this is a table that I have created. So these four fields, currently we do not have any records in this table. So now I am creating Informatica mapping to load this data. So here in sources I have taken employee details and employee tables. I am assuming we all know how to take this sources into the source analyzer. From source tab, import from database, and you can connect to the respective database and select the table. That's it. So now I am creating a mapping. Mapping create m_join joiner. So I have created from sources. I am taking the required sources. So employee and employee detail. So these two are our required sources. So basically it is a target one, sorry. So it is an employee table. In employee table you have three fields, and another thing is employee details table. In employee details table you have two fields. Now I am taking a joiner transformation as stated in our PP team. So in mapping designer tab under transformation, create a transformation. We have to select the joiner transformation, and the naming convention is like JNR, and transformation name is up to us. So under transformation tab, create, taking joiner JNR underscore EMP details. I have created a joiner transformation. So for this transformation, I'm mapping all these fields into this transformation. So by default, these are detail records, and these two are master records. So now I'm taking the join conditions. So here this is image. As stated in this image, in condition tab we can add a condition. So in condition tab I am adding a new condition, employee number. By default it is set to, from master table it was employee number, and from detail table it is set to employee number. And coming to the properties tab, so in properties tab we can see the type of joiner type, nothing but. So these are all the fields. Anyway, so these are the joiner transformation types, defining the join type, nothing but. So as we discussed, this joiner transformation supports normal master outer, detail outer and full outer joins. So we can use this condition in multiple, nothing but these join types across multiple tables. So it is under properties tab in the transformation option. So in the properties tab, so this is a join type. By default it is normal, so we are also taking the normal join type. I am taking the target transformation now. It is employee detail. So from master table I am taking these two fields, and from the detail table I am taking department number and salary. So I am saving the mapping. So we can create a workflow, nothing but we have to create a session and then workflow, or else directly we can create a workflow. Here directly we can select generate workflow. So workflow is non-reusable session, nothing but the session will be used for only this respective mapping. So this is the session suffix, sorry, prefix, and this is the workflow prefix. We can change it as we require. Next, finish. So I am opening workflow main design Mosquito designer. So I'm disconnecting the session and again connecting it. So in workflows tab we can see WF underscore journal. So open the folder and then open the workflow and run the workflow. So before that, just verify in the target table for the data. In target table we do not have any records. Just I'm running the workflow. So in monitor we can see we haven't configured the database connections. We should configure the database connections. So by default the connection will be pointed to some default database. So with the source database connection, it is source database, and detail also set to source database, and target is pointed to target database. It should pointed to target because our table present in exist in this target database. So now we can run the mapping. So if we look into the previous error, we can know it is due to some connection issue. This session down. Control F, fail. Prepare fail. The invalid object name is error because in the WAV database, nothing but the respective database will not have this table. So now I changed the connections into source and target databases. Now I am running the workflow. So it ran successfully. If we look into the target database, so as we discussed, this record should be present in our target database with the respective values. So here, whatever the data that is existing employee details table with the employee details, those are existing in our target database. So nothing but the data which is existing exists for the employee numbers. So for this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I'm loading only for these employees. I'm taking the department number and salary values into the target table. So I'm not considering these records. So if you like to consider these records also, we need to go for some other join type. So the sum of the join type is nothing but in general transformation, if you go to the properties tab under join type, you should select the sum of the general transformation based on our requirement. So this is the our mapping. So I think everyone is clear, right? So I'm hoping you are clear. If you have any questions, you can send it to me.